Monday, May 22nd, 2023, Barry Funkhauser here with Joe back from vacation, and it looks like I brought the clouds with me, Joe. I apologize for that.
Yeah, you're coming in hot today, man. You sound like you're very energized. You must have had a great vacation.
I had a nice siesta off. Yeah, it was fun, but it was overcast when it wasn't supposed to be, you know, so it was, you know, one of them gloomy kind of weekends or weeks.
But you went to the beach, right?
Yeah,
spent
time on the beach listening to the shore and had a good time. But I'm happy to be back.
Well, it sounds like it. It sounds like you're happy to be back.
What'd you do, Joe, while I was gone?
Oh, I got a story about my run that I cannot share on air because it makes me look like a horrible, horrible human being. So I'll share that with you privately, though, later. Besides that, it was okay. I guess I'm just, I am looking for work and I am preparing for my upcoming trip back east.
Yes, you going back to D.C. in that area, that's going to be fun for you.
Yeah, D.C. and New York. I'm hoping when we're in New York, there is an outside possibility that we might be able to go see Billy Joel at MSG. It is a long shot. Tickets are really expensive, but we're gonna play the waiting game on StubHub, and so Friday night, June 2nd, at about 6 p.m., I'm gonna log into StubHub and see if people start dropping the prices for their tickets.
Okay.
One, I've never been to MSG. I've always wanted to go to Madison Square Garden, and two, I've never seen Billy Joel, and I hear he is fantastic live. So, I'm trying to get two.
For obstructed view seats, would you do that?
That was the only ticket available still through Ticketmaster was the obstructed view ones. And I'm like, paying $600 to sit behind a pillar all night? No.
Some people are. All right. Well, here on the left coast of California, we're gearing up for a big event in August at the Ventura Harbor Village, and I'd like to bring on members of the Canine Adoption and Rescue League. Car and Grace are on the program. Hello.
Good morning.
Good morning. Thank you for having us.
Okay, so you are public. No, it's not public. It's you are volunteer. You are volunteers, right? Is that the right word for it?
Correct.
Now, what gets you interested in volunteering for something? Why'd you decide to go with Carl to volunteer?
Okay, well, this is Grace.
Hi, Grace.
And I started volunteering with Carl 20 years ago when I adopted my first dog. I rescued from Ventura County Animal Services because I'm here in Camarillo. And I knew that I wanted to get involved after I got such a great dog.
Oh, well, tell us about your first dog. What dog? What kind of dog was this?
So Jackson. Was
What a great name for a dog.
His kennel name was Action Jackson.
That's even better. Oh my God.
Even better. And I had been fortunate enough to finally buy my own place and I could have a dog. So he was a black lab shepherd mix that was found as a stray. And he was just so cute and quiet. And we got him home and I just, seeing him blossom, whatever word you want to use. I am kind of from the East Coast. Where'd this come from? I use my English. I just knew I wanted to give back. And, I had seen something for Carl. I think I did an internet search and I went to my volunteer orientation and I went home with a dog to foster that day.
Oh, wow. That quick?
That quick. And then I was just, that was my thing.
You were hooked, huh?
I was hooked.
That's usually how it goes when you adopt, isn't it?
I think so. There's nothing for me. There's nothing better. You get home and the dog's checking things out and they can finally kind of lay down and relax and know that they're not at a kennel or, you know, a shelter where there's 100+ other dogs barking and, you know, I mean,
they can enjoy the quiet.
Enjoy the quiet and know that they've got people in the home that are there to, you know, be part of their pack.
That's awesome. Carr, did you have a similar experience getting into dog adoption and volunteering?
Well, I have to be perfectly honest with you. I was actually brought in by Sharon as paid staff, as a manager. And,
oh, wow. Okay.
Yeah. And so I have background in fundraising. I used to work at the Santa Barbara Rescue Mission.
We love Santa Barbara. I'm a UCSB grad.
Yes, I'm a Santa Barbara native. That's where I grew up. That's where I have my children.
Yay. Well, which high school did you go to? Did you go
San
to DP?
Marcus.
You are a San Marcus kid. Woo! Oh, gotcha.
Go
okay.
Royals. Go Royals.
Well, I didn't expect this Santa Barbara connection, but yes, great.
Well, hey, I'm sorry. I'm a Newbury Park Panther, so I don't know.
My cousins lived in Santa Barbara, and they were DP kids.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah.
And I'm a Camarillo Scorpion, so I beat all of you with my steam.
No, my husband's a Scorpion, so I get it.
Oh, Scorpions all over. Okay. I'm sorry, Carrie. Go ahead.
You're good. So I actually was going for a different position. I was brought in as a manager because Sharon wanted to take advantage of my skill set and talents and my creativity and enthusiasm and my absolute passion for animals. And I too have rescue dogs. Our family only adopts rescue. We don't ever buy. We don't believe in it. There's just too many dogs out there that need homes. So when I found this job, and actually I was working at another position at Jenny Craig, 2 months before they went completely under. So
right. Carl, it sounds like you got out at the right time.
Yeah. Jeez. I jumped ship and got on the team with Carl, and I love what they do. And I love coming to Carl and talking to the animals. And I now am a volunteer, and my son is a volunteer, and we're going to be walking the dogs and playing with them and talking to them, because I talk to animals. And so I'm so excited, and I just am so thrilled to be on the team.
That's so cool, Carl. Okay, so we'll talk about Carl in a minute, but I have a side question, because some of us here listening and on the podcast are in the job hunt, and you it's probably around the quarantine time where you were on the job hunt yourself. How was that? How has that changed? Like, Can you give us some insight on how to find a job around now?
Oh, man. Ooh.
Yeah, big question.
Yeah. So I say apply like crazy because it's really difficult to find a job these days. You literally have to put at least, I would say, 30 to 50 resumes out on Indeed, ZipRecruiter, and the like, to even get a few interviews. Now, of course, everybody's different, and everybody, you know, some people are more marketable than others. You know, I have certain skill sets, but you really have to be tenacious, do your follow up, you know, make sure you do your research on the company before you go to your interview, so that you're, you know, when they ask you questions about the company, you know, right off the cuff, everything about the company, their history, things like that. I did that I had an interview at Chick-fil-A, and they were very strict, and you had to know the whole history.
For Chick-fil-A? Really?
Yes.
And you don't need, I mean, working at Chick-fil-A, you don't get any kind of the validation or the the warm feelings that you get working with animals, though. So I don't understand.
That's true. I mean, it was a community outreach position where, you know, interacting with people, but I don't think you can compare that to.
Yeah, right.
Working
go ahead.
I'm done.
Okay. I was just going to ask both of you, how is fundraising and volunteering working for a nonprofit? Because I suspect both of you have worked in, you know, for-profit industries, things like that, in different ways. How is it different? Yeah. How is it different working as a volunteer for a nonprofit that you wholeheartedly believe in, as opposed to just working for a paycheck?
Oh, well, I think you get a lot more satisfaction out of working for a nonprofit because usually you're following your heart and your passions. I do work a 9-to-5 job. I'm on a break right now.
Okay. Congratulations. Everybody needs a break.
Taking your coffee break with us, Grace.
You know, it's easier. It's not easier. It's different. You know, when you're trying to fundraise and help your organization, whatever it may be, in my case, you know, puppies, it's just throwing it out there with your heart and being sincere about what you're doing. And, you know, back to what you were saying with COVID, tanked everything. It was so hard to keep going and asking people, you know, for funds to help with the organization. And it's amazing because people did step up. But, you know, one of the reasons we're getting back into the Pooch Parade after having been on a hiatus for 3 years is just we need to, you know, get back up there, and we need to continue working for the dogs. And with the prices of everything going up, you know, we appreciate people wanting to still, you know, donate to our organization. But going out there with heart and just knowing that this is your passion, and hopefully connecting with people that feel the same way.
Did you, during COVID, did you and C.A.R.L. see an increase in the number of dogs being dropped off at locations like C.A.R.L. or other shelters, things like that? Because I know, you know, the financial, you speak about the financial hardship that literally all of us went through over the past 3 years. Did you see an impact when it came to, you know, dogs, cats, other animals being dropped off at shelters?
I think we did see we did get a lot more in that were like seniors and had medical issues, but we also had an uptick in some of our adoptions, you know, with some of our middle-aged dogs or younger dogs, because people were home and had the time to take care of them. So it was nice. A really odd situation.
Yeah. Now, Grace, you're the legacy here at C.A.R.L. You've been doing it for longer than all of us, I think. Can you tell us about how much it's changed over the years and like this, a little brief history your world?
Brief history, you know, it has been, you know, C.A.R.L.'s been around for a while, since 1996. So, you know, we've moved from different locations. We've had, you know, we started out kind of foster based with dogs that were kept at a boarding kennel. You know, we evolved to have the funds available to actually purchase a kennel. So, C.A.R.L.'s Pet Care Center is a public boarding facility that is open, obviously, to the public. Board your dogs there. The funds after operating expenses go back to our dogs. It also gives us a place to have dogs that are not in foster, that you know, have a place where we can 100% look after their well-being. As with anything, you know, got to maintain. As C.A.R.L. said, she's actually paid staff for the Pet Care Center. And then she volunteers with the nonprofit C.A.R.L., you know, Canine Adoption Rescue League side. Most rescues don't have that ability. And the C.A.R.L. Pet Care Center opens up, you know, to rescues as well, that we can give them a reduced rate to board with us. And then we've got, you know, volunteers that do all sorts of different things. You know, we've got a walking crew that goes out to the kennel to walk our dogs that are you know, boarded there and not in foster. You know, so we're trying to, so we've evolved, as you said, from being, you know, a foster-based organization to being able to purchase a facility, which comes with its own goods and bads. And, you know, just trying to keep up with the amount of dogs these days that now that people are, you know, going back to work, the dog that they had 100% at home with them, who's now being left at home, that's having separation anxiety, is coming back into the rescues. You know, it's a cycle.
Yeah. And, you know, this property that Carl's on down in the Santa Paula border of town, it's like football fields big. So like there's a lot of
dogs need area to run, man.
I mean, it's impressively large, but the first thing I thought was, boy, who gets to mow this?
wait, isn't there a goat version of Carl where you could just bring in goats to, like, you know, chomp on all the grass? That would be
I hadn't even thought about that one.
You know, that's what funny. I think that would be some symbiosis right there.
Okay.
We do. So,
yeah, there's goats.
We actually have volunteers that come out and do some of the facilities maintenance because, you know, the staff are busy taking care of the dogs. And while get out there and help with the landscaping, it's our volunteer base that does so much of the, I'll say, beautification.
Right, because it's you know, volunteering, there's a lot that goes into it to run an organization. It's not just caring for the dogs. Like you said, if you don't keep the facility updated and looking nice and attractive, why are people going to want to drop their dogs off with you? You know, you got to make the place look nice and look inviting and like a place that looks like dogs want to live at.
Yep. And if a landscaper wants to come out and sponsor their time, we're more than happy to take them up on it.
Larry, let's do it.
That's right. Do it. There are volunteers needed in a bunch of different arms of Carl. There's one that's really cool, the thrift store in downtown Ventura. If you are like me and like thrift store shopping, there's one right next to the hospital there that's completely... They're the best priced, and I'm not being like, not because I'm part of it. They're just a very good store. So, and you know, they also do recycling. There's a bunch of things you can do to be a volunteer, and you can go to carldogs.org to become a volunteer, or just click on the link on the in the podcast description. And we're doing something super fun, Joe. This is like super duper exciting because I love, you know me, I love pomp and circumstance.
I just like the circumstance.
And there's a big event coming up in August, the Pooch Parade.
Yay!
Who wants to talk Pooch about it? Car, can you talk about it?
Car, do it.
I'd love to talk about it. So we are having our Pooch Parade return to the Ventura Harbor Village, and that's located at 1575 Spinnaker Drive in Ventura, and it'll be in the big grassy area. Everybody knows about that grassy area.
Yep.
We all bring our dogs there to play.
Yep.
And it's going to be a superhero theme this year, so I'm super excited about that, coming from my old business I used to have, which was costume characters. Ooh. So, this is going to be a fun one. And so you can dress up yourself and your animals and come to the Pooch Parade. You can be a walker. You can put a team together, like if you have a family.
My gosh. Oh, I just figured out the greatest costume idea, too.
What?
Oh, someone could take this one. Make your dog Rocket from Guardians of the Galaxy, and then you are Groot.
Oh my gosh,
it's
that's
perfect.
Cute.
Perfect.
Or you guys are
Star-Lord.
That's right, either one. It's like, it's perfect. And it's so topical because the movie just came out. Oh my gosh. This is fantastic. Okay, continue. Go please.
You're cute. Okay.
Oh, wait.
What?
Didn't Superman have a dog?
Yeah, I think he did.
Super. I'm sure. Oh, what is Superman's dog's name? Oh, I got to figure it out. Okay, keep talking. I'm going to figure this out.
I think
okay.
It was a border collie.
Was it a border collie? I'm sure it was. Okay.
Crypto. And you're right. It was a border collie.
She's good. I used to have a border collie. They're the best. Okay. So back to what we were saying. We're going to have a silent auction. And we're going to have a great DJ, you know, his name's Barry.
Yeah, I'm spitting on the wheels of steel.
Mr. Funk Ooh, going in.
Mr. Funk. That's Funk. Right. Yeah. Your name. I love it. And then we're going to have our vendors. We already have 5 vendors coming. Actually, Dee Dee's Dog Spot's going to be grooming the dogs that are adopted for free before they go home. And she's also going to do trimmings, I think, on nails while people are there. So that'll be cute. We're also going to have an agility course.
Like at the Westminster Dog Show?
I'm
sorry. I get really excited about stuff because this is like so fun.
I haven't been there, so I don't know, but it's.
Oh, yes. You never like watched it on television? No. You know, like, they jump over the stuff and they go through the tunnel and then they have to go up the ladder and down the ladder.
Oh, yeah,
and
then yeah. Okay, yeah. So, yes, like that.
Yay. Oh, I'm totally going to this.
How to do a visual.
Cool.
Yes.
Oh, so
and
oh, this is so good.
I can't wait to see a bunch of dogs not know what to do.
That's the funnest part.
Yeah.
Because then the humans start doing it, and then the humans start doing it, and then when the human starts going into the this is just so much fun. Okay, go ahead. I'm so sorry. Car, are you yes. still looking for? You say you have 5 vendors already, which sound like awesome vendors.
Yes,
going to help out some dogs. You need more vendors, right? How does a business, Barry, like Dudley's Records, how does a business come and become a vendor for the pet parade, the pooch parade?
So what you do is if you're a nonprofit, it's $50. And if it's just a for-profit business, it's $100. So it's really affordable to be a vendor. And you just fill out the little application, pay the fee, and then we provide you with, a tent, some chairs, and a table for your booth for free. And so
you're telling me that a for-profit business for $100 gets instant access to thousands of people in a day for $100?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. My gosh. That is a steal. I
Not
am a
only
marketing
that,
person. I am. If I had a company, I would be jumping all over this. Oh, my God.
Well,
gosh,
it kills a lot
steal.
Of birds with one stone. You know, I mean,
Well, we don't want to kill birds.
We kill like
birds. No, we're not killing birds. It's just. You know what I mean? So, you know, you get to get your name out there, get a lot of exposure. You get to be a part of the community. You know, you get to support Carl so we can do our work and we can rescue more dogs and provide them with the greatest care ever. You know, and it's a write-off. So, I mean, it's a win-win-win.
And have you all been to Ventura in August on the beach?
Yes.
It's spectacular.
Beautiful sunsets. The
I would pay $100 just to sit in that park and enjoy myself for the day.
I know. I mean,
so I don't understand. Like, how do you not have 100,000 sponsors already?
I don't know. Well, we've been trying. We're working on it. We're putting the word out there. We're also looking for sponsors. We have 5 sponsors already, but we need more. So a big sponsor has been Boone Graphics. They really helped us jumpstart this year. So I just want to give them a little shout out.
Your graphics done at Boom Graphics, boomgraphics.com, everybody.
Yeah, in Santa Barbara.
Boom, baby.
Oh, and even better, they're from Santa Barbara, dude. Buy stuff from Santa Barbara. We love Santa Barbara.
Well, Boone was actually named after Boone the dog, and their little logo is Boone, which was I think it was a black lab. So there we all love dogs, and it takes a community to raise the funds we need to save more dogs. And we're going to do it in a really fun way. at Pooch Parade.
That sounds awesome. Now, Carr, I really need you to reach out. Speaking of Santa Barbara, really need you to reach out to Pal Peralta Skateboards. Because, because they are a Santa Barbara company. And two, they support animals.
Do they so really?
You might wanna reach out and look at
them. I'm going
to
do that.
Good company.
Yes, thank you for that. I appreciate that. I will hit them up.
All about it.
Yeah.
It's a hard job fundraising, let me tell you. You know, you do a lot of knocking on doors and you just keep knocking till someone says yes.
Yeah. For $100, Pal Peralta will be like, for less than the cost of one of our skateboards, we can go down and hang out with all of these awesome dogs and people. Yes.
Or maybe they could be a sponsor and you also get to have a booth as well. So, and there's a lot of extra benefits of being a sponsor.
Oh my gosh. And isn't there a skate park right there in Ventura Harbor Village?
Yeah, there is.
There's a skate park, right? It all works out. You got to call them. You got to make
it
up.
They'll do it.
You know what? They might even say like, oh, you know what? Oh, Ryan Caballero, he's going to be available that weekend. He'll just come out to the skate park and he'll skate around for people. That'll bring out even more people. Oh my gosh. Oh, see, this is what I do for work. So it gets me excited.
Well, if you are a vendor or interested in the Pooch Parade up in August, it's happening after the Ventura County Fair. So you go to the fair and then you go to the Pooch Parade after. I think it's like the week after.
I guess the week after.
It doesn't matter.
Yeah, dude, it's a lot of party going on with your pooch. And if you'd like to be a vendor or take part in this in any way, you can visit our website, carldogs.org. That's where you can get all the information about the Pooch Parade. Man.
And you can get out there and take pictures with Barry, too, because Barry, you're going to be there, right? DJ B-Funk.
I'll be too busy playing dog songs. I already have 13 of them. I think I need 6.
Oh, nice, B.
Yeah. Barry. So I just want to... You guys are so silly.
She's gonna sit there and laugh, but Barry, I will tell you, we usually start off our Pooch Parade with the teams and the dogs in costume with who let the dogs out.
Okay. Just of course. Hiya. I could do that. Well, I usually end the podcast with the horse duck question, but it feels a little crass, doesn't it?
It does feel a little crass for this one, yes.
I mean, my secondary question would be, who is your favorite dog and why? And it has to be a
favorite celebrity dog.
Somebody that this dog has to have a lot of friends.
Okay, I see. I understand.
Can't be like your buddy's dog down the street.
You've never asked me this question. Why haven't I ever gotten this question?
Okay, well then, how about you as the co-host? You can answer it first while the lady...
Yeah, because I'm totally...
Pluto.
Pluto.
Pluto's my favorite dog. I'm a Disney guy. Sorry, I can't help it.
Well, there's another dog in Disney.
Oh, hey. Hi, Disney girl. Do you like Pluto as well? Goofy freaks me out. I'm like Sheldon Cooper in that way. I can't do Goofy, but... Is Goofy even a dog?
Goofy is a dog.
Yeah. Yeah,
it's dog. Okay, that's like in Disney lore. Goofy is a dog because I know
Goofy is a dog. Goofy is a dog, but has more of a main character role. Pluto's more of the actual dog character.
Yes, that's why I like Pluto more. Yeah.
Right, you got to always have a sidekick in Disney. That's the rule.
Yep. I would be the sidekick. Barry would be the main character. Okay, Grace, who is your favorite celebrity pooch?
I don't know. You know, I'm going to have to go with Doug from Up.
I agree.
Girl.
I agree. Doug is my baby.
Oh, he's awesome.
Who's Doug?
Would you like to be my friend?
Squirrel. Would you like to be my friend? I love that. Oh, he talks. Dog.
Yes.
Hey, my name is Carl. Would you like to be my friend? My name is Doug. Would you like to be my friend?
That's the best movie.
It made me cry. I bawled at the beginning of that movie. Oh my gosh.
Oh.
Well, you know, it happens. I have empathy. It happens.
That's what good movies do to you. They make you emote.
Right.
All right, Carr. Did you answer already?
I'm sorry. What's the question?
She said Doug as well. Doug from up.
Yeah, I said Doug. I agreed. I was right along with her.
Grayson Carr with Doug.
Everybody.
Yes, Grayson Carr. And,
okay. All right.
I feel like Grayson Carr should have a show.
I agree. Yes, so we should do that.
Our names are great.
I'll produce it.
Okay.
Thank you so much for coming on the program tonight, carldogs.org. Hopefully we'll have you on again before August. If anything in your life happens, let us know. We'll talk about it on the show. How's that?
Sounds good.
Sounds good. Thanks, Barry.
Thank you for having us. It's been fun.
Okay. Now hold on a second. We have to leave with the song.
Yes.
And I really don't want to play the Baja Men.
Just do it. Just get it over with. It's like ripping off a band-aid. Just do it.
Okay, here it comes. Thanks. All right.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
Well, the party was nice, the party was bumping. And everybody having a ball. Until the fellas started in calling, and the girls respond to the call. I have a poor one shout out.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
I see the young people at a ball, 'cause Billy Bonders get out. Get back, Gruffy, bash Gruffy. Get back, you flea infested mongrel. Gonna tell myself I'm man, no get angry.
Hey, yeah,
to any girls calling them canine. Hey, but they tell me, hey man, it's part of the party. You put a woman in front and a man behind. I have a woman shout out.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
Gruffy, bash Gruffy, get back, you flea infested mongrel.
Well, if I am a dog, the party is on. I gotta get my groove on, got my mind, I'm gone. Do you see the rays coming from my eye? Walking through the biz, the Digimon is breaking them down. Me and my white socks, short, dill, and gancy color. Any caliber, I think I knew, that's why they call me Big.